Yo, what up, man? It's your boy, Sid the RC Guy, down here in the basement, as we do oh so often, here with a how-to video. So, ProLine has put out three awesome interiors. You have the Cherokee, the Toyota 4Runner, and the C10. But, in the C10, you see these awesome seat belts that you unfortunately don't get. But, I'm going to show you guys how to make them today. And they're real simple to make. So, we've already got a set for the driver's side in here. So now we've got to make a set for the passenger side. But I'm going to walk you through how easy it is. But we're going to need a few things. Black and silver paint, shoe goo, a ruler, a small flat tip, some kind of a marker, some paint brushes for the painting we're going to do, an x-acto knife, and super thin ribbon. Now you guys can choose whatever color you want. I went with black because it's kind of a neutral. But generally speaking, back in the day, the way they did this is everything color matched. But we did ours in a different yellow anyways, so I figured black is going to be kind of neutral, so this will help out. Plus, I want to make more seat belts besides this. And we also need styrene, also known as evergreen. I got the thin kind because I'm going to show you guys here in a bit. So we're going to bring the camera up. We're going to make this happen. So I actually forgot two tools that I needed to tell you guys about. Some kind of a sanding stick, a lighter, and super glue. You'll see why here in a bit. So we've already got our stuff measured out here of what we're going to cut out. As you can see there, we got our belt and our buckle. Now, you, like I said, we can either take an X-acto knife and we can cut these out, or this material is actually thin enough that you could take a pair of scissors to cut out the main shapes. So we've got our two main shapes there. Go ahead and trim this here. And be careful not to take too much material off. Now, what I would do is I would heat up your X-acto blade. And then push through. Once it cools, sand down the excess, go ahead and cut them apart. You can do your final sanding. After many attempts, finally got it through. So, now what we want to do is we want to check the other one as well. And I think we're going to need to do the same kind of deal. Take some tape, simply like this. Tape it down. Tape these down. Take your silver. And then cheat, hit with the heat gun. All
All right, now that we've got it nice and just about dry. And you can also do this with paint pens or markers. So now we need to paint the hole. And you could cut it out, but to make life easy, we're just gonna go ahead and paint it. And then paint the push button. And we'll let those two dry. We're gonna come over here and make our holes. Now, normally in the old school buckets like this, there was a driver's seat, a middle person seat, and a passenger seat. So we just want driver and passenger. So what I did is I counted over seven spots over, or six, I mean. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let me double check that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So as best as you can, line it up center of where that is, and then just give it a nice little push in. All you're trying to do is make a big enough slit to get the seat belt through. That should be plenty big. And then repeat. At the edge. Like so. Another thing that I would advise, after you paint this, guys, take some shoe goo and run it all along these edges. These edges are a little thin, so that'll help protect your interior. Alright, now that the paint's dry, take yourself some super glue. Got some ProLine tire glue here. Works just as well. You're gonna add just a little bit right along the edge. And then you're gonna fold over. Try not to glue your fingers together. And now you have a completed seatbelt. Well, boys and girls, hopefully that helps you out with your ProLine interior. Like I said, they offer three of them, the Cherokee, the Toyota 4Runner, and the C10. But it would be nothing to modify these and make them fit in other vehicles as well. So thank you guys so much for tuning in. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, or thoughts, make sure to email us or leave info in the comments. You can email us at sidtherc@yahoo.com. Also, make sure to check out rcbasement.com where you can buy these products. And as always, guys, keep your lipos charged. We'll holler at y'all later. Peace!